Hey guys, TechNumager with a video for you guys. In today's video, we're going to be reviewing the iPad Air 4th generation, or the latest model of the Air that you can get. Give you guys a rundown of what's good, what's bad of this iPad in mid-2021. It's been almost 1 year since this iPad was released. There's also the Pro model and then the regular edition of iPad. So what do you really need to know about the iPad Air 4th generation? All of that we're going to break down. But before we dive into today's video, if you guys are new to the channel, we do a lot of tech news reviews and giveaways. So make sure that like and subscribe button. Also, if you guys are in the market for an iPad at a discounted price, make sure you guys check out the links in the description section. So let's dive into today's video. The iPad Air 4 is the fourth generation of the Air model, and this is the latest model. It was actually released in October of 2020 along with the iPhone 12 lineup, which the iPad of course got overshadowed because everyone loves iPhone. It's not something that people look into, but the fourth generation has a lot of unique features that come with it. You can actually get this model in Wi-Fi or the cellular one. So the model that we have here, of course, is a cellular one, a little bit cheaper than the this is the Wi-Fi model, which is cheaper than the cellular one. This one has a couple configuration here. The configuration we have is the 64 gigabyte one, which is starts at $599. Versus the other one that you can get, which is the 256 gig, which is a little bit more pricey. You're paying around $749. So depending on what you get at in terms of storage, you're going to be paying a lot more. There is no mid-tier, which Apple did have like 128 gig, maybe around $649 or so, but obviously that didn't happen. You'll notice a lot of things have actually changed with the Air 4 from the previous generation. It has the body of the iPhone 12 lineup as well, where the edges, bezels are pretty flat. So you notice this flat, more futuristic design, although Apple did kind of go back on the design from rounded edges to bringing that flat bezel. It's a little bit thicker. It weighs around 1 pound or so. It's not too heavy for an iPad. That's generally the specs around the weight of it. You'll notice things like the speakers here. It does have dual speakers here on the sides and some on the other side as well. You notice other things such as the camera here and then the microphone on the back here. And then this color, of course, it comes in multiple different colors. There's actually 5 different color choices. This one that you see is actually a shade of the sky blue one. There's also green, rose gold, space gray, and silver edition that you can purchase this device in. So if you didn't like one color, you can definitely go with another color. Of course, gives you a lot of customization there to go with it. And now let's talk about some other feature of it. So the iPad Air 4 generation, unfortunately, although it was released in 2021, where Face ID seems to be the standard, Apple backtracked and still has the Touch ID as the option to unlock and lock your iPad Air 4. So which didn't make sense to us, because there is a front-facing camera that's here, right here on the iPad. So you really could have Face ID, but Apple did not develop that capability. You also notice the screen size display here. We're holding it landscape, but this is actually a 10.9-inch liquid retina display that you see with a 2360 by 1640 pixel resolution, and it has a max brightness of 500 nit compared to the iPhones, which have almost a 1200 nit. It doesn't seem as bright, but it is definitely bright when you turn off the brightness settings here. And that's to goes that, you know, of course there's other things with the display itself. It does have a fingerprint resistant coating on top of it, so you won't see as much smudge, although if you look closely you'll start to see that if you use it, you do kind of form this coating depending on how oily your fingers are. Another neat feature of the Air 4 that we know of is that the chipset on it. So it has the A14 Bionic chipset, and if you guys know, the A14 Bionic chipset is also a feature of the iPhone 12 lineup. It's probably the fastest chip Apple has developed, as or so Apple has claimed, and they put it on this iPad, and that makes this iPad just slightly better in terms of performance when you compare to the Pro model, which of course is a lot more costly and it's a little bit more pricier than the Air model itself. The Pro models, which has the A12Z, when you do some single core testing, you notice the A14 Bionic chip beats that in some of the benchmark testing we see. So chip wise, Apple did definitely go ahead, did the right thing, putting in that powerful chip on this device. Along with that is the camera here that we will notice in this iPad. Is the camera, if you notice on the back, that single camera, wish it was a double camera, that definitely would help Apple's cases. But this is a 12 megapixel camera. Of course, it's capable of recording in 4K, just like you would on iPad. So you're able to record in 4K, 60 frames per second. So you're not missing camera on this. For your selfies and your FaceTime is 7 megapixel, which Apple could have done better. We think it could have gone with the 12 megapixel camera like they have done with the iPhone 12 lineup. Again, something that Apple could have done better, but that's the way it is. Now let's talk about the battery life on iPad. So that's one of the great things why people purchase Apple tablet instead of Android is the battery life you get on this device. And Apple does hold true to its battery life. On this iPad Air 4, we've seen up to 8 to 10 hours of lasting on a full single charge. Of course, it depends on what you're doing. If you're playing a lot more heavy graphic game or multitasking, have a couple things going on, multitasking or switching between on and off your devices, you're probably going to be seeing somewhere between 7 to 8 hours. But if you're using it lightly for just streaming and doing simple stuff and using it for social media and things like that, you'll probably get that close to that 9 to 10 hours of video playback on this iPad. So now let's move on to the software of this device. This software that it comes with is iOS 14, specifically designed for the iPhone 12 and this model of iPad as well. And this is what makes this iPad something worth to note, is that this, because it is running on iOS 14, it's going to be relevant for a good 4 to 5 years. That means the iPad, it's going to be supported for another 4 to 5 years, so nothing to worry about. You're going to get all the major updates. You're going to get the security updates and the feature updates that come with it, which, again, because you're paying for that price, you get that sort of software stability that Apple has promised. Of course, even beyond that software life cycle, Apple tends to support their device, which is something we found better in terms of comparing it to the counterpart Android tablets. Let's move on to the next feature of this iPad that makes this iPad quite interesting for us, is that it's actually able to support Apple Pencil, the second generation, which is the latest version of the Apple Pencil. So we're able to do a lot more with the Apple Pencil. You're able to use it to do a lot of your artistic design and artwork that you would like to do. That's possible. You can use it, of course, to do a lot more with the Apple Pencil integration if you're using it for Procreate or whatever digital format of art, or if you're a designer. We find that Apple Pencil just is extremely well when it comes to that sort of integration here. So it's something, of course, you'll see and you'll love, and this is why what makes this iPad better than the previous generation of Air and better than some of the other models that we've seen in the previous generation. So you're going to be able to use that. The other feature that this does have is the accessibility of being able to use it on a smart portfolio. So here, as you can see here, we have the smart portfolio from spec here. We can actually have this sit right here. So we're going to go ahead and plug it in. And it's a smart portfolio, which means if we close the lid here, it will close out. And we can do a lot more with it. It also has integration to the Magic Keyboard. So if you guys aren't sure what the Magic Keyboard, it's simply in terms of the iPad. You can actually use the Magic Keyboard, which we don't have here with us, to simply turn this iPad into a mini laptop, which you can do most of the stuff. Of course, you're going to be stuck with the apps that run on iOS. There's apps that just simply can't run on iPad, like some of the photo editing tools that you can only get on the MacBook. So do be aware of that. But because of this couple of accessories that are supported on this iPad, it really does make a huge difference when we are reviewing this iPad in 2021. So now let's talk about the overall pros and cons of this device. So let's start with the pros here. Of course, we've seen the new design. That's definitely a plus that Apple has finally shifted its design of the Air model to something more unique. It does have the A14 Bionic chip, which again, you've seen here, the same chip that's utilized on the iPhones, which of course makes this device more interesting and allows us to be able to do more graphic heavy games like the ones that you would play on the console. So that's going to be a unique feature of this iPad that does come with it. The other thing to note about this iPad is that enhanced CPU and GPU comes with a 4 gig of RAM, which of course some of you might not care, but when it comes to gaming, when you need speed, that's going to be something to look out for, is the RAM that this iPad has. So this iPad, you can pretty much use it for more intense stuff that you would like on any other device for your gaming needs. Of course, you can do use things for your school, your work, any sort of productivity, to even to degree photo editing. One thing does kind of start to see that it does lack is when it comes to video editing, especially around 4K. So if you're editing 4K video, because 4 gig might not be enough, you might have to grab a MacBook or another laptop designed specifically for graphic video editing in 4K. Other thing to note about the Air 4 is that its compatibility with the Apple Pencil makes it a great device when it comes for your sketching need, your digital art, which again is another pro to it. Another thing along with that is the battery life. Of course, 8 to 10 hours is a great battery life, especially on a tablet that you need on the go, especially if you're, depending on your usage, if you're using it for maybe 1 to 2 hours a day, it could last you good well over a week or so. And with the USB-C capability charging, not the Thunderport, this actually charges way faster than the previous generation of iPad. Makes it a great device for faster charging. So when you need to go on the way for a more faster charge, this is where the iPad does definitely come in handy for being able to charge much quicker than we have seen. And with that, the last pro, of course, is the unique feature support of Apple Pencil and other accessories like the Magic Keyboard, Smart Portfolio, and much more. So what are the cons of the iPad Air 4? Well, the iPad Air 4, if you think about in terms of the other iPad, it's not quite the Pro model, but you're not paying the Pro model price. So some of the features are missing, such as the Face ID, which, well, of course, Apple could have done that. We also notice here on this device is that on the back camera, if you didn't catch on here, is that the back camera does not have a flash. It's not a big or deal breaker for the iPad, but a flash would definitely enhance the photography on this iPad, and it's something we wish Apple have done, but they didn't. And the other thing to note is it only has dual speaker compared to the Pro lineup, which has quad speakers. So whenever you're listening to music or video streaming, you may not get that intense or fully usage of your speaker, but again, it still does have great speaker phone to it. So the last con probably for this device is that the price point, of course, you're paying almost $600, where you can get an iPad 8th generation around $300. So you're paying almost double the price with some of the added features. Of course, the performance on the Air are a little slightly better in terms of benchmark compared to the 8th generation. So if you're budget friendly, you might be going with the 8th generation versus the Air. But the Air, because of its compatibility with some of the accessories and that premium design and the improved hardware, it's probably the reason why you're looking to go with the Air instead of the regular 8th generation iPad. So there you guys have it for our review of it. Hopefully this review was helpful in terms of if you guys are looking to buy this device. Also want to hear from you guys if something we missed, any comment, experience you guys had using this device, leave a comment in the comment section. Thanks for watching, guys. See you guys next time.